I did some work off camera to flush out the rest of the entity and transforming, coloring. So all of that is made into event sourcing. But if we load up a new page, we don't see the previous state because we haven't created a snapshot yet. So in this video, I wanted to work on snapshotting the events so that we don't have to process old events. So I want to create a new context for snapshot. So let's create that module. This module will contain functions for, let's say, clearing a snapshot. Snapshot one word or two? Let's make it one word. Snapshot. One word. Okay, so what does it mean when you clear a snapshot? You should delete all entities and components. So, do we have a method for that? Let's look in the spaces. Look at entity Okay, you can delete entity. Entities will delete. I think we'll have cascading deletes, right? Because if you have components, let's check the migrations. References, entities. On delete will delete all. So you just need to delete all the entities and everything else will be deleted. So I think let's research this ecto delete all. Delete all in your queryable. Okay. So, repo all query. What's the query? We're going to need the space ID. Query will be from entity in entity. So, we need to import a couple of things. We need to alias er space entity where e space ID is equal to ID. I think that's it. Down here, e exists. Parentheses at this from. No. Something. From. Oh, so very similar query. I'm gonna grab this. From E in entity, here. Base ID equals ID. Can I use space ID outside of the match clause? I have to import something at the top right. This should help. Little queries and use query. All is undefined. A repo is not everywhere. Okay, that. Okay. So that'll clear a snapshot. And what about a update snapshot from given a space ID starting last sequence. So what this will do is go to the spaces. XR spaces. Spaces stream our event stream with the space ID and last sequence. Give you a list of events and you can reduce over the things in an initial thing, which I'm not sure what that is. I think that it could be one query, but I'm not sure. You could just write every time you're processing the event. Let me see how multi is used here. Multi-new. Multi-insert. Multi-da-da-da-da-da. Could it be this, where you keep iterating over all the events and anything that needs to be created, you put in there. Anything that needs to be updated, you put in there. But if it's already in the create, then you just update inside the create. So you just create it once. Anything that's in the delete, you delete from the created. But then you need to, if it's recreated, you could put it back in. Could get a little tricky. What happens if you ask for something to be deleted, but then you create it? Do you remove it from the deleted? Well, it wouldn't be possible because if you delete something and then you create it, you're going to get a new ID. So you can only create and then update and then delete. In which case you have to remove the unique ID from both create and update. We also don't need to necessarily optimize for this right now. We just need to save it into the database as a snapshot. So why don't we just go through every event? Just process each event. So enum dot each events function event, and we'll just call process event. Problem here is we don't know the space ID, so we need to pass that in. We can create this because we had something to create an entity before. Let's borrow that from spaces where it's create entity. And here we go. Copy that. So what are these entities? So we got a whole bunch of member movements, but we can look at the types. And this gives us a representation of what that data looks like. We can get entity created. So we're gonna want the event, which is a map with atom keys. So we want the event type. Sequence, do we care about the sequence? Yes, we do want the sequence. And everything else can go here. So we have the event type and the event. So if the event type is, remember. Sorry, entity created. Something like this. Entity build default components with these attributes. So entity created comes with a component list. paper. Build default components takes type. Unless you pass in. You only do this if it doesn't have components. Otherwise, components looks like this, which is an object. And we've kind of switched it up. Switched it up. Let me look at the entity model from the migration. So it has an ID, it has a name, it has a type, space ID, parent ID, child count, and really that's it. Okay, so creating the entity. It's easy. Not a lot of these are required. Creating the components, it's a bit tricky. ID, name, type, space ID. So, enters will be ID. Is the entity ID. So the payload process ID becomes entity payload, and then an ID like this. It's the ID. The space ID is space ID. The name. So let's get to the payload. Payload equal to event dot payload. In fact, can destructure it this way, that the ID became the ID, the type became the type, the name became the name. Components. And we could even say that all these are in the payload. We could just structure it here. So event is this object with event. Payload. Fitting So your attributes become ID, space ID, name, type, and components are the components. Now, what are our components? Our components are something that looks like this, which I think we can just save it that way as well. What's going on here? Variable event is unused. So adders, and then, so here we have an array of this, yes. Now what does build default components do? Set components into adders means it's going to put into components where it's a map of type and data, which that's exactly what we want, isn't it? The only thing it breaks is this polymorphic embed thing. Or you can say it's a type, which was useful in the forms, sort of. But somewhat hard to understand. But good for validation. So you could say that a field is a type of position, so it has to match this color. But all of these are objects. And so we get kind of strange when color is not an object, it's a straight string. The documentation for polymorphic embed. Even in the email, it's still embedded schema, a complex type. It's always an object. Yep. So that part's a bit weird. Float string vector. You know, I don't need it to be an object. It could just be a string, and I just stringify it. I actually don't need it to be something that is parsed, because we just want to store it, right? And we're going to blow it away. What do I need components out here like this for? I can make each component hang off of the entity. Could have components as a polymorphic embeds many. List of polymorphic embeds. Field context is an array of polymorphic embed, and the type of this can be that. Types, location, da 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 da. That's how we're using it. Types. Yeah, each one is still an object. But in our case, it really could be an object because it could be a type, which is the name of the component, the type of the component with data. So each one of these would be an object with a type and data, and the data could be. String, it could be whatever. That might will be worth investigating. Okay, so let me write down this idea. Idea to explore instead of a table of components, you try polymorphic embed list of polymorphic embeds on the entity schema. So you can have types, so the types of component can be color, position, rotation, the XR spaces, what? Yeah, something like this. Each polymorphic type is an object like another type, which was this field type is a string data field data is a So for color, it's a color string. So let me see, color string. You can validate the color string here. Versus just data, and it's a so data could be a string when color, or it could be See, I wonder if you could. Field. I mean, can you say that it's the XR components float or something? Schema is not a valid type for field value. Did you mean to use belongs to have on that? Embed schema custom field type. I guess I have to do this. Other data, or maybe array. Embedded schema array, embedded schema array or list. Array of map. array of numbers. Okay, we can do that. Array anyway, we could look at that. So take a break here.